Hello again. Okay, this is not a normal review, really, as most of my reviews, if not all of them, are based on my customised pistols. This is a standard pistol review, and it's all about, as you can see, the Tokyo Marui Night Warrior come MEU 1911 pistol. Now, first impressions, I personally don't like the look. Tokyo Marui, for some reason, obviously it's to do with licensing and so forth on how they can mark the pistol up, but they've called it a Night Warrior, but it's actually a mishmash between Springfield Armoury and Kimber designs. They've tried to make the Riz Rail look like a Kimber. It doesn't. It's a very, very poor representation. But that said, it's a good Riz Rail, and I'll come to that in a minute. The markings, not that good. The Night Warrior markings, I think, look absolutely horrendous. But there you are. There is no markings on the other side, other than the standard Tokyo Marui Custom made in Japan, whatever. But there's no other markings, apart from on the barrel as well. So yeah, markings wise, not that good. The grips, another poor point on these. These grips are awful. They slip in your hand. They're not very good at all. They're based on Kimber grips. Now, whether the real steel ones are rubberized, I'm not sure. Maybe they grip more. I'm not too sure on that front, having not held real steel Kimber grips. These plastic based ones are rubbish. They are absolutely rubbish. This pistol has been given to me on loan from a friend to do this review, and he admits these grips are not the best. He's thinking of swapping them out. The ones that come with the standard MEU actually are better than these. These just don't grip at all. They just don't grip. They just slip in your hands. Okay, moving on to a bit more of the cosmetics. All the other parts on it are pretty much identical to the MEU. There is no real difference. The only other difference is, obviously, is the silvered barrel bushing, silvered barrel, and the silvered hammer. But other than that, they're identical to the MEU. Right, okay, good points, additional good points compared to the standard MEU, are obviously the Riz Rail and the sights. Now, the Riz Rail first, yes, it doesn't look like anything that the real steel pistol would have on it, but it works. So if you're a hardline skirmisher, you can't go far wrong than that. This is my M3 torch. It's a Garda one. Fits on, and it's quite sturdy. It's not going to come off. For your finger, to flick on the torch, dead easy. Very, very ergonomic. Two-handed, quick use of the torch. It works. Exceptionally good Riz Rail. It's tough. It's not going to move about. The fixing of it is very, very good indeed. It's plastic, yes, but well, Tokyo Marui, they're not metal, they are plastic. I personally used to own a WECQB pistol, which I believe now they class as the Wilson Combat. I think SOCOM Gear do it now as the Wilson Combat. That had a Riz Rail, very similar to this. It was rubbish. This pistol would not fit to torch would not fit to it. And I had no ends of problems with it, so as soon as I sold that, it was the better really for me. This Riz Rail works. That's all I can say about it, and that's all you guys really need to know. It works. Simple as that. So if you're a skirmisher, you're using it in night games, can't go far wrong, and you want a 1911 look pistol, you cannot go wrong with this one. Okay, second benefit, sights. Exceptionally good sights. At last, Marui have put on what I term as realistically good sights. They are very, very large dots. Good, clear, clean sightline picture, whatever. Very, very good indeed. Can't say any more about them. There's just one slight drawback. They are not glow-in-the-dark sights. They are not night sights. But you can always add that yourself. You can get glow-in-the-dark paint, which you can put a little dollop on each one of the dots. And there you go. But other than that, very, very good sights. Another benefit with these sights is the notch that's cut out. They're actually, I think, based on Heine rear sights, because Heine, I think, came up with that design. Reason being, if you're incapacitated in your left or right hand, whichever hand you shoot with, and there's no way to grip it with another hand to rack the slide, how do you rack it? Easiest way is catch that on the edge of a table or wall or your belt, whatever, and it will rack. That's all you need. So good little design, like it. So yeah, sights exceptionally good. So as I say, it's got its good points, it's got its bad points, this pistol. I personally would swap out the grips, and put on more grippier grips. But everything else I would leave for skirmishing purposes alone. It's a good pistol. It works well. Feet per second is 265, I believe, to about 290. And mind you, that was in fairly cold conditions and only using 134 gas. So, I mean, if you use green gas on it or whatever. Now, actually, talking of gases, everyone says, oh no, you mustn't use green gas on Tokyo Marui plastic pistols. That actually is a myth. You can use them now. Tokyo Marui have really done their homework on their build quality. You're not going to crack a slide, not unless you use red gas on an extremely hot day. Then, yeah, you will blow a slide off. In fact, you might even blow the chamber as well. But if you're using it a hell of a lot. But with green gas on these pistols, yes, you can use them. No worries at all there. So as I say, that's a bit of a myth. Their old, Tokyo Marui's old original M9 pistols were susceptible to blowing slides, I believe, and other parts, because their plastic wasn't so good back then and their robustness. But the robustness of these pistols has been proved time and time again. I run all my pistols on green gas and never had any problems. So yeah, that's a bit of a myth. So if you're out there wondering what gases you can use and whether it's safe, yeah, take it from me, you can use them. As long as you're not in like Saudi Arabia or somewhere like that where the temperatures are right high in the hundreds, whatever, then obviously you're going to not need green gas. You're only going to need 134 or whatever, because the air pressure alone will give you power anyway. Accuracy wise, with the use of the hop up, which I'll show you now, it's a standard Marui hop up, no difference at all. There is one other thing I don't like about these MEU pistols, and this one, is the flush slide lock lever. It's a real pain to get out. You cannot get it out with your just pushing your finger in there. It never works because you can never grip it the other side. In fact, I'm going to be lucky this side and actually be able to do it, but there you are. But 9 times out of 10 in the field, you can't do it. It's a pain in the arse. So that flush side to the slide lock is not very handy at all. The only other way you can overcome it, if you want to overcome it yourself, is to countersink that hole slightly. Not a lot, but just enough so that it gives you a bit more purchase on it to be able to push it through. Okay, coming to the hop-up adjustment. I'm not going to touch this because it's adjusted exactly as my friend likes it. But your hop-up adjustment wheel is there. If you turn it that way, i.e. clockwise, it takes the hop off. You turn it anti-clockwise, it puts the hop on. So you've got two different adjustments there. Okay, simple, standard Marui hop-up adjustment. Nothing special, but an exceptionally good and well-tried hop-up on that. So for accuracy and so forth, it is very, very good. And range as well, it does help with range. Okay, that's pretty much all you need to know on the internals. As I say, accuracy-wise, it's brilliant. I'm hitting, I think it was about a 3-inch target at like 25 feet, something like that. 3-inch size hole, so that's pretty good. And that's rapid firing as well. I mean, single shots, I was getting a little bit closer, I think. Feet per second, 265, as I say, to 290, which is standard for 134 gas. Although I'm using 0.25 BBs, not 0.2s. You can use either, but I always use 0.25s. It just gives you a bit more accuracy and hit weight, really. So there you go. So yes, the Tokyo Marui Night Warrior, I can recommend wholeheartedly. It's a nice little pistol. If you like the 1911 single stack design, can't go too far wrong. Comes with a riz rail built in. The sight's exceptionally good. As I say, the only thing really that's a downside on it is the grips. Other than that, you can't go too far wrong than the TM.